According to private sector players, the 2021 National Coffee Act still has gaps that need to be addressed. The chairperson, Uganda Coffee Federation, says the act does not address the aspect of access to affordable finance, especially for primary processors, farmers and businesses in coffee.
As private sector, we are not against being regulated because we have invested a lot of money and we need a regulated and organized industry. So we want the regulation. People shouldn't do things that jeopardize our investment, but also would like to have progressive regulation that supports doing business.
Minister Frank Tumwebaze says the private sector players' financing concerns are legitimate and need to be resolved. He adds that involvement of the private sector is critical for local coffee value addition.
We will need your help, and you would draw in also NPA, say that we get the product. So we will not reinvent the wheel. As far as coffee is concerned, the only demand I make is that you must listen to the concerns of the brewers who are the private sector.
The National Coffee Act 2021, which His Excellency the President assented to on the 31st of August this year, will further facilitate the development of a competitive, participatory, and sustainable coffee subsector. In accordance with the National Coffee Policy 2013.
Uganda's monthly coffee exports surpassed 500,000 bags in July 2020 and kept rising and peaked at 700,250 bags worth $70 million in the same year. However, to maintain Uganda's current uptrend momentum and consolidate gains in the sector, all stakeholders must support the different government programs to increase production, productivity, marketing and consumption of coffee. Coffee production in Uganda stands at approximately 8 million bags per year. Story by Nelson Mandela Mohozi for the news.